Students, this is Bharti madam. We are going to learn a new topic, accounting for partnership basic concepts. From this topic, one question will come for 6 marks and one question for 5 marks in the practical section. Now come to the next definition of partnership. According to Indian Partnership Act 1932, section 4, it says that partnership is a relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. According to this definition, we can come to know that in case of a partnership, at least there should be 2 persons. And our intention is to start a business. When it is to start a business, it means we want to earn is the profits. And whatever are the profits, those should be shared among the partners. It is in an agreed ratio, and if there is no ratio, it should be equally. And the business can be carried on by all the partners, or it can be looked after by all the partners, or any one of them can look after on behalf of the other partners, and this we call it as a mutual agency. Come to the next. Features of partnership. First one, 2 or more persons. In order to form a partnership, there should be at least 2 persons coming together to form a common goal. Come to the second one, agreement. Partnership is the result of an agreement between 2 or more persons to do the business and share the profits or losses. The agreement may be oral or written. As per the Partnership Act, it is not mentioned what the agreement should be. But it is better to have a written agreement to avoid the disputes, quarrels, and the misunderstanding among the partners. Third, business. You know that students, whatever we are doing, it is an economic activity. And when it is an economic activity, we are interested in earning the profit. We have invested the money in the business. And whatever economic activity we are doing, it should be, in the eyes of law, treated as a legal business. Come to the next. Mutual agency. The partnership business may be carried on by all the partners or any of them acting for all. Here, the partners by his act is bound by the act of other partners with regard to the business of the firm. The relationship of mutual agency is important. If there is no mutual agency, there cannot be a partnership business. Next, sharing of profits. Whenever there are the profits, even there may be the losses also. Whatever is the profit or the loss, it should be shared among the partners in an agreed ratio. And if there is no agreed ratio, it should be equally. Next, liability of the partners. In case of the partnership business, the liability of the partners is unlimited. It means even the personal property will be held liable for the payment of the business debts. Come to the next. Partnership deed. I told you partnership is an agreement between the partners. When it is an agreement among the partners, the agreement may be oral or written. The Partnership Act does not require that the agreement must be in writing. But to avoid the complications, disputes, quarrels, and the misunderstanding among the partners, the agreement which is in writing, duly signed by all the partners, and prepared according to the Stamp Act, we call it as a partnership deed. Come to the next, contents of partnership deed. names and addresses of the partners. Second, firm's name and its main business. Even here the subsidiary business should be mentioned. Third, amount of capital contributed by each of the partner. Fourth, accounting period of the firm. Fifth, profit and loss sharing ratio. Sixth, rate of interest on capital, loan and drawings. Next, salary, commission payable to any partner. Next, rights, duties, liabilities of each of the partners. Next, there are many other contents, but you require only any two contents, okay? Come to the next. The provisions in the absence of partnership deed. So, if there is no provision regarding the following items in the partnership deed, how will you treat them? And most of the times, this question will come for practical for 5 marks. First one, interest on capital. If there is no provision, at that time no interest on capital is allowed to any of the partner. Second, interest on drawings. No interest is charged on the drawings made by the partner if there is no mention in the deed. Next, interest on loan. If any partner has advanced some money to the firm beyond the amount of his capital for the purpose of the business, he is entitled to get an interest on the amount at 6% per annum. Next, salary or commission. No partner is entitled to get the salary or commission or other remuneration for taking part in the conduct of the business of the firm unless there is a provision for the same in the partnership deed. Next, profit sharing ratio. If the partnership deed is silent about the profit sharing ratio, the profits and losses of the firm are to be shared equally by the partners irrespective of the capital contributed by them. Now students, it is asked for 5 marks in the practical. So, interest on capital. Just you put a dash, write not allowed. Interest on drawings, put a dash, not to be charged. Third, interest on loan, put a dash, write charged at 6% per annum. Fourth, salary or commission, put a dash, no partner is entitled. Fifth, profit sharing ratio, put a dash, write it as equally by all the partners. Come to the next, maintenance of capital accounts of partners. Mainly there are two methods of maintaining the capital accounts, and the first one is the fixed capital method, the second is the fluctuating capital method. Now we'll go on to the fixed capital method. Under the fixed capital method, the capital of the partners shall remain fixed unless additional capital is introduced or a part of the capital is withdrawn by the partner as per the agreement among the partners. All the adjustments like the share of profit, interest on capital, interest on drawings, profit and loss appropriation share, all are recorded in a separate account called partner's current account. The balance of this account remains fixed or it does not change, and we call it as fixed capital method. Now come to the format of the partner's capital account under the fixed capital method. Right at the top,
partner's capital account. Debit side to bank, that is the withdrawal of the capital, if any, made by the partner. Next, come to the credit side. By balance brought down, that is the opening balance of the capital of the partner. By bank, that is a capital introduced or the fresh capital by the partner. Now close it. Whatever difference you get, that is the balance carried down, that is the closing balance of the cash of the or the capital of the partner. Come to the next, current account.
Now come to the debit side. If there is any opening debit balance, it should be taken to the debit side. Next, drawings made by the partner. Next, interest on drawings of the partner. Next, profit and loss appropriation account, that is the share of the loss. Come to the credit side. By balance brought down, and most of the times the current account will be having the debit balance and the same will be brought down. Next, commission payable to any of the partner. Next, salary. Next, the interest on capital that is allowed as per the partnership deed. Profit and loss appropriation, that is the credit or the profit of the appropriation account. Next is the balance carried down if it shows the credit balance. And if it shows the debit balance, that balance carried down will come to the debit side. Come to the next, the fluctuating capital method. Under this method, the capital account is only maintained, that is the only account maintained. The capital account of the partner goes on changing or it goes on fluctuating the balance. All the adjustments such as the share of profit or loss, interest on capital, drawings, interest on drawings, salary or commission to the partner, etc., are recorded directly in the capital account of the partner. And this makes the balance goes on fluctuating from time to time. And it is called as a fluctuating capital method. Now come to the format of the capital account. Come to the debit side. Drawings made by the partner. Interest on the drawings are charged as per the deed. Profit and loss appropriation account if there is any share of loss. Next, credit side. Balance brought down, that is the opening balance of the capital account. By bank, that is a fresh capital introduced by the partner. Salaries, interest on capital as per the partnership deed. Profit and loss appropriation account, that is the share of the profit. Now whatever difference you get, it will come to the debit side and write it as balance carried down. It means it shows the debit balance. Come to the next, distinction between fixed and fluctuating capitals. First one, on the basis of the number of the accounts. In case of the fixed capital method, two accounts are maintained for each partner. In case of the fluctuating capital method, only one account is maintained for every partner. Come to the second one, on the basis of the adjustment. In case of the fixed capital method, all the adjustments are made to the current account. In case of the fluctuating capital method, all the adjustments are made to the capital account. Come to the next, capital balance.
In case of the fixed capital method, capital account remains fixed. In case of the fluctuating capital method, the balance of capital account fluctuates or it changes. Next, credit balance. In case of the fixed capital method, the capital account always shows a credit balance. In case of the fluctuating capital method, the capital account may show a debit or credit balance. So students, this is regarding the partnership and the basic concepts. And I told you from this topic one question will come for 6 marks. In my last class students, there was a student who had asked me a question regarding what is incidental trading activity. Now I'll tell you the meaning of that word, what is incidental trading activity. For example, with regard to the canteen, they are providing you the services, but they are providing you the services with the intention of making profit. For example, with regard to the tourism, or with regard to the transport, or with regard to any of the banking, they are providing you the services, and they are not the not-for-profit organization, but their intention is to make a profit by providing the services, and we call them incidental trading activity. Next students, one more question was asked to me. If tournament fund is given in the balance sheet and there is a tournament expenses, what should be done? So students, if there is a tournament fund and tournament expenses, take the tournament expenses to the liability side of the balance sheet. From that, write less or deduct tournament expenses, and the balancing figure, take it to the liability side of the balance sheet. Okay students, if you have still any more difficulties, you can ask me or you can put it as a comment, and later on I'll go on explaining it.